ورجوت عيني أن تكف دموعها يوم الوداع نشدتها لا تدعني ورجوت عيني أن تكف دموعها يوم الوداع نشدتها لا تدمعي أغمضتها كي لا تفيض فأمطرت أيقنت أني لست أملك مدمعي ورأيت حلما أنني ودعتهم فبكيت من ألم الحنين وهم معي مر علي بأن أودع زائرا كيف الذين حملتهم في أضلعي
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear and beloved brother, the news has reached me about the loss of your wife. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have maghfira and rahma over her. And I wanted to express my condolence at that. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant you sabr and ihtisab in facing this calamity. Our raja in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that her suffering has ended. And our aza and dua is that her soul is now in crops of green birds, suspended from the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, enjoying the rivers and enjoying the fruits of Jannah as she wishes. As young as she was, rahmatullahi alayha, she was an exceptional woman of our time in various ways, in her commitment, in her sacrifice, in her dedication, in her patience, in her istiqamah, in her yaqeen, inshallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's in the hearts. Many men, and big names for that matter, have been touched with maybe an ounce of what she was touched with, and they couldn't endure it. She died suffering from torture, for her Islam and for her Tawheed. And she died at an age, rahmatullahi alayha, where most women of today haven't even begun their lives yet. She spent her life, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best what's in the hearts. She spent it in ta'ah and mostly in one of the best deeds, which is طلب العلم, until she died in sujood rahmatullahi alayha. And if we were to cry, really it would be us weeping over ourselves, to cry in dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses us with such a righteous death. And I assume, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, is that it was deep secrets with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was intense dua in her loneliness, and after the torture and during the torture that she endured in this path, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed her with such a righteous death. And we'll find out when we discuss this on the thrones of Jannah facing one another, inshallah, ikhwanan ala sururin mutaqabilin. She listened to every one of my lectures and took notes until her very last days, from what I was told, until she died in sujood. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, يُبْعَثُ كُلُّ عَبْدٍ عَلَى مَا مَاتَ عَلَيْهِ. Every servant is raised before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the same state that he dies upon. And there's many ahadith that support that. And rest assured, my beloved brother, our dua and dhan in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in what we know, our dua and dhan in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and what we know of His rahmah and what He prepared for her and her likes, is to raise her before Him in sujood. And it's su'ud dhan in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to think that one raised before Him in sujood will attain anything less than the highest levels of Jannah. That's our dua, that's our dhan in Allah. And I mention it to soothe your heart, my dear beloved brother. And Allah is my witness, when I hear of someone on pure tawheed, especially our sisters, but everyone on the pure tawheed who's harmed or was harmed or is in agony, it's more than if I was inflicted myself. That's why I refer to this calamity as ours, not just yours, but our solace and comfort comes in making dua for her, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants her the level of the shuhada. She died, inshallah, steadfast, suffering from the torture of the tawaghit, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to paralyze the hands and destroy and dismantle the hands that touched and harmed her and caused her the internal bleeding and suffering that she endured. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala obliterate their wealth and nations. And your solace and comfort, my brother, is that she will be bi-idhnillah, means for you to elevate your rank in Jannah to her level. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تبعتهم ذريتهم بإيمان ألحقنا بهم ذريتهم. And he said, أدخلوا الجنة أنتم وأزواجكم تحبرون. And he said, جنات عدن يدخلونها ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم والملائكة يدخلون عليهم من كل باب. He also said, ربنا وأدخلهم جنات عدن التي وعدتهم ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم. From the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and from the glad tidings, from the na'im and delight of Jannah, and in order to delight the eyes of the people in Jannah, is that He enjoins the spouses and families together. He raises the spouse in the lower level to the spouse in the higher level so they can enjoy Jannah together. And you've indeed succeeded in choosing a wife, inshallah. If I look forward to meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, having such a student, then I can't imagine how you should be feeling having such a wife. My beloved brother, have sabr and ihtisab, because trials befall all of us. But we, as muwahideen, take them with sabr and ihtisab. Affirmation after affirmation in the verses and throughout the Quran tell us that we will be tested with trials and tribulations and the loss of loved ones. In specific, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة وأولئك هم المهتدون. والأنفس is what you're enduring, the loss that you're enduring now, loss of the loved ones. Our condolence, my brother, is that this dunya is vanishing and temporary. By Allah, I see it as if it's just moments before me and you are where she's at today. When I was informed of the death, rahmatullahi alayha, and I was told of matters that you only read about in the books of the Salaf, you may ask the one who conveyed the news to me. From nearly the beginning of the conversation to the very last moment, I wept and cried. And I'm sure you're weeping as well, and I can't blame you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam wept before us at the loss of his son. Abdurrahman ibn Auf said, O Messenger of Allah, even you weep? The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the eyes weep, the heart grieves, but we only say what pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةً قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَّبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower her with His forgiveness and mercy. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant her firdaus and the companion of Ammar Sumayya. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you sabr. Allahumma ighfir laha warhamha واعف عنها وعافها وأكرم نزلها ووسع مدخلها واغسلها بماء وثلج وبرد ونقها من الخطايا كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس وأبدلها دارا خيرا من دارها وأهلا خيرا من أهلها وزوجا خيرا من زوجها وقها فتنة القبر وعذاب النار. Please stay in contact if you need anything, my dear brother. جزاك الله خيرا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.